Giving a quick review of these brand new Jack Specific Sonic 3 the Movie Hedgehog figures. We're looking today at Tails and Sonic himself. So there's quite a few others in the wave, but we'll get a look at them later on another time. Just a quick one on the packaging. Sonic, if you want the UPC for that, there is the number if that is of help to you in trying to get hold of that. And for Tails, the UPC, if it's helpful to you, there it is on screen. So we get two really articulated figures. I'm genuinely very surprised with Jack Specific, who've surprised us all recently as well by doing pretty articulated Simpsons figures. So they've really kind of came up a little bit in my estimations after really being stuck doing Mario figures for years. So kind of impressed by what they've been doing here a little bit. Packaging is pretty straightforward and simple. On the back, you can see some descriptions there for Tails in multiple languages. Doesn't tell you too much. We get a look at the character there. Good luck trying to get his tails to stand up in the background because they're really heavy, thick plastic. We do get 20 points of articulation, and again, there's the cross cell there showing Robotnik and Shadow, the other figure, which I had my hand in, I should have bought, but I did not. But still, even a really good Robotnik figure nonetheless, so definitely try and pick them up. If you're a Sonic fan, you will not be disappointed. Packaging is all very generic there with Shadow up at the background. Tails, Knuckles, and Sonic, etc. So there will be other waves of these figures to come, but all very generic packaging apart from the back. And there's a little bit there for Sonic there too. If you want to freeze frame, you can read a little more on him. 22 points of articulation for him, and again, just that cross cell on the back. And again, the front of the packaging is generic. And that's that. So packaging out the way, let's get a look at these two figures overall. And oops, Sonic is just desperate to just fall over. In terms of height, Tails is coming in at kind of 4.5 inches or about 11 centimeters. Sonic, when he's standing up properly, is about 5.5 inches or 14 centimeters tall. Just trying to give him a little bit more of a dynamic pose without him falling over. But yes, in terms of some quick comparisons, there they are next to Homer. There's a recent Mattel Master of the Universe. What else have I got kicking around here? We've got a G.I. Joe figure. Some people love all these examples of height, etc. So look, it's got to fit on your shelf. It's a video game character. It's not quite going to be exact to maybe what you wanted, but it does look pretty good. Let's get a closer look at them and see what's kind of cool about them. Let's zoom in on Sonic and bring in the focus. How cool does that look? It's just a really nice rendition. The way they've done the clear plastic with the eyes, with the kind of print underneath that layer of plastic, is really nice. It gives it that nice kind of glassy effect. As you can see, the shine goes across it there. And that's really quite a cool Sonic. It's got a nice effect to it with the blue ripples in the hair, the pink ears, more kind of tan colored ears. And it's not bad. It's what surprised me more was the articulation, the fact that it had some. It's even got butterfly joints. I mean, for a Jack Specific figure, that's pretty good. That's not the right way to get that arm. Let's get that way. There we go. So yeah, there's a lot of articulation here, which we'll get to talk about in just a minute. But first and foremost, obviously, is the face and the head. And it looks good. He's got a big noggin on him. There's no doubt about it. He's got his little spikes coming off in his hair there, painted on. But that's a big head. If we zoom, there's a lot of weight in that plastic. And it's not light and empty. It feels pretty heavy. Maybe light inside, but it's heavy enough for a very thin-limbed figure. What Jacks have done, at least, is given us a pretty reasonably thick body and limbs that are good enough in proportion. It will stand up, but that head, again, is pretty heavy overall. So if I try and even just stand him straight up, he should be fine. He's got nice big chunky shoes on him, but he does tend to want to fall back a little bit. So anyway, just be aware when you're putting that on the shelf. Along the rest of the figure, we've got his white gloves. Pretty good too. And these very cool sneakers, trainers, whatever you want to call them, runners. Gutties if you're from weird parts of Scotland. So yeah, nice shoes on him with cool socks effect. It's a genuinely nice figure. I am just so surprised by the articulation on him though. It is just Really unusual, but very, very welcomed. So Sonic's noggin, his big head is on a ball joint inside there. It's a little difficult to see, but there's no extra flexibility. So you've only got, that's it. And it's such a shame if they'd given that a hinge, Sonic could have looked up and, but you will at least get left and right and slight tilt, but that's it. So a bit of a shame, but that's the way it is. The head kind of rests on these little Sonic tail pieces almost at the back of his headrest, and we've got this tiny little rinky-dinky tail going on down there. And as I said, the rest of it is just gloves and shoes and Sonic's bod. But when it comes to that articulation, you can see butterfly joint up at the top. Really, it's just incredible for a figure of this price point. Then we've got a hinge up at the top of the shoulders, which again gives you that extra, as you can see there, really different kind of flexibility and range you can have. You've then got a swivel up at the top of that shoulder, which is just ridiculous. You've got a single joint at the elbows, but it's so deep and so good that it's ridiculous again for this a figure like this to have that. Look at that. That's a single joint. That's phenomenally good. We've also then got not at the wrist part there, but the actual wrist swivel back and forth and articulated fingers. I've never seen this on figures of this price range. So incredible to see that you get this articulation on them. We've also got a swivel waist, which again is not bad. I would never have expected a swivel waist, but it's got one. So pretty good. Up at the top of the legs, we've got a little pin up at the top there, which gives you a thigh swivel. Single joint at the knees, but it's a great joint. I mean, look at that. That's phenomenally good. That's really, really good. A lot of double-jointed figures don't give you that range of articulation. Very squeaky. Yeah, anyway, down to the ankles, which don't actually rotate round, which is very surprising, actually, given all the rest of it. But no articulation, no rotation, I should say, at the bottom of the ankles. But what you do get, as you can see that giant hinge there, is basically a kind of ankle pivot. It's not a great ankle pivot because the socks get in the way, but still pretty good. No, oh, there is pegels. There you go. I stand corrected. I thought there was no pegels. So that'll help you get a really good running pose on them. God, those knees are so squeaky. But you can get some really cool poses. I'm just trying to pull back a little bit just so you can see what I'm doing. You can just add some really dynamic kind of stuff. And he might not stand too well, but you go, he's actually standing. That's for a budget figure. Go buy it, honestly. Just so good. They nailed it for this Sonic. I guess what they're going to do with this one is potentially repaint, repaint, repaint for different effects. But I mean, it makes sense. It is very much the kind of Jada Toys-like model. Make great figures, invest in the figure, and then you can literally repaint, reuse the thing multiple times. That's fabulous. So the only real downside, I think, to Sonic, I would suggest, and the joints are really quite stiff, which is great, actually. It gives you plenty of, they're not too loose. The only real kind of, I guess, letdown is the head articulation. So you're so limited by it. It's a bit of a shame. A stand would have been great, but I wasn't expecting it at this budget price point. But what a great little animated figure to have in your collection, and even just put maybe with other figures if you want to do kind of mock-ups and things like Street Fighter versus Sega or whatever you want to do, something like that. But it looks really, really good. So I'm very impressed with Sonic. Let's go look at Tails. And again, he pretty much echoes the same good vibes that Sonic has. When we look at his eyes, you see again that kind of way they've done the plastic with that kind of glassy shine over it, which just, I mean, look at him. It's Tails, man. It's so cool. It's just really well done. The little sprig of hair looks good. The way that the sculpt is captured, all the fur looks good. Got a good smile. The print looks good, looks sharp. Just excellent. Really, really good. Coming down to again to the knees, you've got some great looking little sneakers, trainers, whatever on him. And he shares a lot of the same articulation as Sonic. Being a little bit shorter, gives him a slight advantage. You know, kind of mega issues on his back that you've got a little bit more for that head to move, but that would not have been hard for Jax to make that head joint just a little bigger to allow you a much more better, sorry, a much better range to go back in terms of articulation, but it's better than Sonic's, that's for sure. But even on this figure, we're getting a butterfly joint. I mean, that's just nuts. They never did this for the Mario line, which is a shame, but yeah, you're getting a little mini butterfly joint on there. You got that hinge as well on the top of the arm. You got a single joint at the elbows, a little bit fragile-y feeling because it's kind of just a bit thin, but it's solid enough. But you can see a little bit of stress already happening on that joint there, so just be careful. And the same for just as Sonic was, it's got that swivel back and forth and articulated fingers, unheard of. As I said, the head you can pretty much rotate side to side and a little bit back and forth. No waist swivel there going on. We do get up at the top of the legs. You can see the hinge on that leg, but you know, great kind of articulation. Single joint at the knees, but again, given the size of the character, that's very fair indeed. There is no swivel again at that elbow there, but you do have rocking ankles and that hinge. So he's got really good range of motion on his legs. And then we come to the tails, which are well designed and well done. So you've got a bit of a kind of Y-shaped stump. And great, let me zoom in a bit there. Great big hinges on this tail, so you can put tails up. And this is the issue I was having. If you wanted to do as the back of the box is kind of showing you, it's just not gonna work. Let me zoom back out. He's just there's too much tail in tails. So the back of the box had him. Let's just have a look. The back of the box has the tails up like that, and he's leaning a little bit forward. So let's see whether that was really staged. So let's turn the tails round and turn them up. And let's see if I can get him to actually stand a little and lean him forward a little. There we go. Let's get that articulation there. Come on. So even if he might stand, maybe. No, he's just way too heavy. So even if I lean him really forward, okay, he will stand. There you go. You got to really lean him forward though, but it's ready to fall over. So that might be where stand comes in and is useful for you. So you can get him like that, but I guarantee you over time, he's not hard to then just tip over. So the tails, I recommend you potentially have like so. And it just will stand perfectly fine. Might look a little nuts, but that's one way you can do it, is at least put one up, one down. Try something of some kind of proportion to get the tails the way you want. But in terms of the look and feel for the character, the articulation on the character, the fact you're getting butterfly joints and all this extra articulation, which is really reserved for much higher end figures, then really, let's face it, what are kids' toys for a kids' movie, or kid-ults, I should say. Whoops. Yeah, you need both tails down. These are really quite exceptional figures. Very impressed with these, but Jack specific. They've really done a solid on these, and I think done some great stuff there. So I'll be looking out for a shadow to pick up to add to that. But yeah, pretty solid. Well done, Jax, for being really surprising this year and giving us two lines of figures that yeah, just genuinely surprised me. Little tweaks could be made, little additions could be made, particularly head articulation, even the same for Homer and all these other figures which are reviewed. Little changes could be made, but all over pretty good figures indeed. Hopefully that helped you if you're about to buy these. And that's it. We'll see you for another video coming up soon.